This 26 Sports and CCTV High School Volleyball presentation is brought to you by Cadillac Casting Incorporated.
And welcome back to Cadillac High School, everybody. Site of tonight's Big North Volleyball Conference meet between the Cadillac Vikings and the Gaylord Blue Devils. A lot of blue out on that floor tonight between these two teams and their jerseys. Second week of Big North Conference action, as we mentioned in the opening. Cadillac comes into this contest 1-0. Blue Devils come in 0-1, but there are only five opponents now, six teams in the Big North, Acacia, and every one of them is important. You get everybody home and away. And the Vikings, as we mentioned last week, along with TC West, have won or shared the title every year. You know the Vikings don't want to lose that streak.
They do not.
This is a Blue Devil team that, as we mentioned, is going to be shifting some things around tonight as senior setter Kendall Jarski will run the show in a 5-1 offense. Abby Beechnaw, who normally would run the 6-2 with Jarski, will move to outside hitter opposite Mary Bailey. The middles will be Elizabeth Hines and senior Casey Cordy. And we expect to be seeing Cordy's name a lot. A very good long jumper and high jumper. She's not exceptionally big for a middle hitter, but she can get off the ground, and we're expecting big things out of her for the Blue Devils tonight. Emily Panazzo will be your opposite. For the Vikings, Allie Finch, the Miss Volleyball candidate, one of 10 finalists for the Miss Volleyball Award, is your setter, running a 5-1 for the Vikings. Of course, Kylie Christensen at 6-1, the senior middle hitter. She has tattooed Tachikara on more than her share of torsos and foreheads in this young season and over her career. Brooke Kahani, the 6'1 outside hitter freshman, had to play middle over the weekend on Saturday, and hopefully she'll be back to her outside hitter position. It'll be interesting to see who gets the call, though, here early, as we were told we might see some different faces. So as we look out there right now, it looks like Gabby Kapuzinski still going to play outside opposite Kohani. No. That looks like the normal starting six to me. Jordan Ellens at the opposite of Finch, Christensen, and Bonesire at the middle. So I believe that's the usual starting six. So maybe we're going to see something a little different later on in this match. Your officials tonight, Jill Baker Cooley is your down ref or ref two. Sharon Lucy, Jill Baker Cooley is your up ref, your ref number one. Sharon Lucy, your down ref, and Bruce Johnson and Gary Rexford, your line judges. Veteran crew. Now, these guys were all officiating when I was coaching way back in the day.
They've been here a while, all of them.
Vikings will serve to start it off. We're underway here in game one. Right away, the slide. Finch now with the big lefty swing. So Finch and Christensen reversing roles there, and they get the kill. Blue Devils right away looking for Casey Cordy. on that slide. Outside swing blocked. Got another lefty setter there, apparently. Finch with the dink. Back outside again. Mary Bailey just tips it over. Outside, Kohani, big swing, and nothing doing. Don't think that crossed the tape.
They're calling it a four.
Jarski serving it up for the Blue Devils. Forces an overpass, opportunity for Gaylord. Bailey, though, can't get it over the tape.
It's really difficult when your setter's serving for them to run up there all the way to the front row.
Well, and an overpass usually is a good thing, right? Because it's a free ball and you can get into your offense. But in that case, she had to run so far to get to that. It's a great point. Finch with the jump float. And now the Vikings with a free ball opportunity. There's the slide for Christensen. Crushed. Jarski nearly dug it up. But nobody could get to the second ball. Boy, Kylie Christensen, that's like a thunderclap when she hits that thing.
I don't think I'd want to be in her way.
Jarski for Cordy in the middle, and we're going to get a net violation on the Vikings. 3-2 Cadillac just underway here in the opening set. Bailey. Finch will run it down. Back set for Christensen, who puts it away. Boy, that's pretty nice to have as a setter. The back bump pass. I've never set officially. That's got to be pretty tough.
Doesn't look like Gaylord's quite getting back to base yet.
Kohani back to serve. There's a quick for Cordy, dug up by Finch. Free ball opportunity for the Blue Devils. Emily Panazzo playing that setter, that opposite position. And there's a nice dink, finds an open spot on the court for the Vikings. They go to 5-2 here in the first set. Panazzo, we talked about the importance of her being able to block that strong side hitter. She's not a very big player out there.
Gillard's up, looks like a pretty short team.
Abby Beach now with a great swing, dug up by the Vikings. Christensen outside. Michaela Johns trying to power tip that one, puts it into the net. 5-3 Vikings here in the first.
Just a few years ago, that would have been considered a throw.
Yeah. Cordy with the jump set, jump serve. Christensen, holy cow! My goodness. Mary Bailey staying in there, dug it up, but it was hit so hard that Bailey put that thing up into the rafters. My goodness. I would just be turning tail to the baseline.
Those are the hits where you just have to put your arms out and hope it goes to the right spot.
Christensen's float serve unable to be passed by Bailey. And it's a 7-3 Cadillac lead. Jump float. Nice, no rotation on that one. Cordy out of the back row. Dug up, and then some miscommunication as Finch chasing it down. Johns trying to stay out of her way, but I think maybe Finch thought Johns was going to go after that. Panazzo back to serve. Kapuzinski, nice pass. Bonesire, and she'll get the kill after the net violation on Elizabeth Hines, the junior middle hitter. Quick substitution for the Vikings as Jordan Ellens will go back to serve and play back row. Jarski outside for Beachnaw. Blocked, gets it back over. Dug up again. And a nice swing from Jarski. And you can see why they run the 6-2. Jarski is a lefty, would be an effective right side hitter.
That would definitely be an advantage. Good spot.
Coach Jamie Seal telling us before the match that they need her offense, and that's why they run the 6-2 normally, and you can see why. Good hitter. Cordy with the dig. Jarski chases it down. Cordy back row. Nice down ball. Dug up, though. Adams. cheap attempt from Jarski. Finch trying to return the favor, puts it into the net. Sorry, Taylor. Adam is the libero for Gaylord. Mary Kate Taylor, of course, the libero for the Vikings. Back set for Kapuscinski, and she'll drive that out of bounds. Eight-seven, Cadillac with the lead. Ellens to Finch, into the middle for Bonesire, and the campfire is set. Finds the middle of the D. Kapuscinski back to serve. Blue Devils were moving around a lot. She kind of double-checked. The whistle had blown, though. Bailey has to send over the free ball. Quick for Bonesire, dug up. Outside for Bailey. And off the block. I believe the nomenclature is tooled the block on that one. I think that's what the kids are saying these days.
It is.
I have no idea. Adam back to serve for the Blue Devils. And Finch finds that same spot that Bonesire did.
She's just such a natural. It's hard to read that tip when she's just flinging it over like that.
Taylor back to serve. Nice pass. Slide for Cordy, and she'll send it wide. But that was well run. Abby Beach now got off a nice pass. Allowed the Blue Devils to run their system, which has been difficult for them so far early in this one. 11-8, Cadillac with the lead. Adam, good pass for Jarski. Outside for Bailey, she'll have to push it and finds the top of the tape. ...12-8 Cadillac. Just underway here in the first set. Jarski in the middle for Cordy. Off the block, dug up by Ellen. Quick for Christensen and blocked by Cordy, one-on-one. Big, big block for Casey Cordy against fellow senior Kylie Christensen.
She was all by herself on that one.
Tough to do one-on-one. Jarski back to serve. Wanted to drop that one in the two zone. That's a tough serve, tough spot. And talk real quick, Acacia. She was aiming for the area where Finch was because Finch is a back row setter in that situation. Or as a front row setter in that situation, she's trying to get Finch to take that first ball, isn't she?
Yes.
Finch with the back row attack, dug up, and that ball's going to be tight on the net. Jarski unable to get to it. It's a tough spot to hit, but if you can force the setter to take that first ball.
Yeah, it can really screw off the other team's offense, having somebody else setting that ball.
Finch. Jarski, middle for Cordy, tries to roll it in the corner. Nice spot, but Kapuscinski is on it. Free ball, though, coming for the Blue Devils. Outside for Bailey. Just pushed it a little too far. That was well run because there was a lot of attention being given to Cordy on that play. Finch back to serve. Oh!
Sneaky.
That's a nice serve if you can get it. That takes years of practice. Adam will have to send over the freebie. She does find Finch. Forces the libero, Taylor, to set that one. And the Blue Devils with an opportunity. Bailey, big swing off the hands of Taylor. And point to the Blue Devils. 16-10. Cadillac with the lead. These two teams have already squared off this year. On August 23rd, the Vikings hosted a tournament, and they played the Blue Devils in the Gold Division quarterfinals after pool play. They were not in the same pool. As Christensen sends that one just wide. And Coach Jamie Seal telling us before the match tonight that her team just kind of ran out of gas and bonked, if you will, in that match. They lost 25-16, 25-2, which you don't see too often. But when you run out of gas, you run out of gas, I guess. on a little tight, and it's going to force Abby Beachnaw to put a shoulder into the net. Side out to the Vikings. 17-11. Cadillac with the lead. The freshman, Kohani, Brooke Kohani, back to serve. Tough ball. Finch with the dig. Taylor go outside for Johns. She'll send it over two-handed, and there was no touch. And so the four contacts will give it back to the Blue Devils.
Gaylord seems to be handling their 5-1 change a little better than I would have expected.
Yeah, Beachnaw's been pretty impressive on the outside when she's gotten good looks. Christensen will roll one, dug up by Cordy. Jarski outside for Beachnaw, into the block, dug up, and sends it over. Finch will try to surprise him with the quick back. Blue Devils are ready.
Cadillac was thinking that should have been a tip.
Kapuzinski's roll shot is dug up. Cordy will send it over. Tough set, and Beachnaw will send that wide. Boy, neither team, Acacia, really got much of a look during that very long point. Really no swings in that point.
Kind of a lot of ugly free balls on that one.
Christensen with the jump float, 18-12 Cadillac. John sends over the free ball. Finch outside for Kapuzinski. Has to go a long way to get that one, and does.
That was a good reach on that one.
Set may be a little inside for her, but she chases it down. And the service winner. I always considered that an ace. If a second kid couldn't touch it, I put that as an ace in the book.
Is that just in your world or in all official books?
I actually think that might be the official rule for stats. Cordy going after that one. Back row puts it down. What a swing. From the pipe position by Casey Cordy. 20-13 Cadillac. Kapuzinski, nice. Well run play there by the Vikings. I have no idea what the Vikings call that, Acacia, but that's not on the last zone on the net by the antenna. That's like two zones in.
It's kind of in the middle of the outside in the middle hitter, yep.
Yep, and there's nobody. Oh, my goodness. Oh my God. You kidding me? Taylor with the dig. Finch back row for Christensen. Rolls. This is still in play. Saved. Finch with another swing. And Jarski will put it into the net. What a point. I didn't see. I want to say that was Ellens who, from her backside, threw up that left hand and got that to go over with a fist, as we've got a timeout on the floor.
There's certainly some scrappy volleyball going on tonight.
22-13. Cadillac with the lead. Hey, want to take a quick moment and thank the local businesses that are supporting this broadcast here on 26 Sports and CCTV. They include Cadillac Casting, Pac-Mail, Bigelow Supply, Douglas, High Point, Cadillac Tire, Pizza Plus, Bowman and Rogers, Crystal Flash, Vickery Financial, and LC Materials in the Concrete Store, formerly LC Ready Mix. Our sincere thanks to each and every one of those area businesses for their support of 26 Sports and CCTV. Big North Volleyball tonight. Jay Simon alongside Acacia Holmes. Glad you've joined us. Vikings looking to put away this first set. I'm told we need to give Mary-Kate Taylor credit for that save. Jarski outside for Beachnaw, and she tools the block. So a good timeout for the Blue Devils. As a coach, you always want a timeout to lead to a side out, right?
Yes, you do. That's the point. get the other team off of their momentum.
Christensen, Finch, back set, Kapuzinski. And over the bench, Jarski unable to chase it down, and so the Vikings now 2 points away from closing out this opening set. Kapuzinski with a laser. And Cordy will have to send over a down ball. Finch outside for Kahani, a little flat, managed to get it to go, and then Jarski with the recovery, and they're going to call it for a lift. That's a tough one right there when it just rolls over. You're not sure as a blocker, should I be up here? Do I go after it aggressively? Is the setter going to touch it? Finch outside for Kohani, gives her another shot at it. Adam with the dig. Jarski outside for Bailey. Drive, double block is there.
Nice coverage by that hitter.
And Finch will have to send it over. And that's the advantage of having a 6-foot setter. It works out quite well. Taylor to try to close it out. Cordy will push it. Ellen there. Christensen unable to put it away. Free ball though coming. Ellen back set. Driven down by Christensen. Boy, she loves that slide. And that will do it for the opening set. Cadillac wins it 25-15. One set in the books. Game two coming up right after this. You're watching Big North Conference volleyball action on 26 Sports and CCTV. Back in a moment.